Now, to reach more people, the Uganda Cancer Institute takes the mobile mammography unit far into communities where it can be very expensive for the average Ugandan to take up routine cancer testing. The bus-like tool was donated by the government of India, and it has already helped more than 500 patients across the country who access the service. Our senior reporter and producer, Razia Athman, has been to one of the outreaches, along with the medical team trying to catch breast cancer in its early stages.
A mobile mammography unit on the move. It brings the much-needed screening services right to people's homes. This may seem like an ordinary bus, but it is a truck well-fitted with equipment needed to conduct special medical imaging. And it is radiation-proof, so those around it are protected. Leah is a breast cancer survivor. The news that her survival needed a mammectomy removal of her breasts scared her. But it's been 2 decades, and now she must undergo routine screening every year. This mobile unit means she can do that free of charge and without having to travel to a hospital.
The doctor told me what you are going to do is to cut off your breast so that you get life again. I got mastectomy. I get other medicines like chemotherapy, radiotherapy, and I took the tablets for 5 years. And I'm still going. Every year I have to go there and they test me, whether CSC, whether mammography.
Up to 500 cancer cases have been diagnosed here since the project was introduced a decade ago. An average of 80 patients can be seen on a given day. Doctors are emphasizing all women and men too come for screening.
We want women to come when they are 40 years and above. But I must add this, and this is a big but, because breast cancer in this country hits at a young age. You know, there are many women who are below 40 years and they have breast cancer. We want also women who are below that age, because in screening, we don't only do mammography, we also do what we call clinical breast exam, where we examine a woman with our hands and find out whether their breast has a swelling that is likely to be cancer, or there is no swelling that is likely to be cancer. So in short, we want every woman to come.
Breast cancer is the second most common cancer in the country. The Uganda Cancer Institute wants to cut that number down. It takes teamwork to conduct a fulfilling day of screening, and that starts even with the driver of the bus.
I feel I should contribute something to the community, and by way to move the bus near to them as they are able to receive the service.
The nursing officer's job doesn't change much, except in the van it gets overwhelming.
What is your experience working inside a bus but providing the services of a nursing officer?
No, I feel still great because this bus provides privacy. And you know the work we do, like for cancer screening, especially in women, women always want privacy. So this bus provides enough privacy for women, and we feel comfortable. You can talk to them anything. They can air out anything because they know no one is listening.
Health education is an important part of these outreaches.
At least in every 100 women, there is one man who has breast cancer. So we expect that after every month, you need to check your breast at home on your own, or you make your husband or your spouse check it for you. What do I mean by checking? Checking is touching to see whether there is some swelling. The swelling may be painful or may not be painful. So if you check it frequently after every month and you find that there is a swelling, please go to the health facility where a qualified health worker will check it for you and do other requests for other investigations.
Beyond breast, cervical and prostate cancers are also screened inside this van with the right medical tools. The radiology department has recently invested in new equipment to further fight cancer.
And then radiology has CT scan. So we have a CT scanner which does imaging, because cancer patients go through staging and restaging, so it is part of the treatment plans to do those imaging to assess how far the disease has gone such that they can treat correctly. And then we also have the mammography, which is this.
Close of business, and the mobile unit takes off to the next location. In a country where access to cancer screening services is inadequate, more mobile units like this one could improve diagnostic capacity. Razia Athman, The News.